yesterday that the differing events or recollections, let's call it, between the organiser and the Prime Minister. Interestingly, this is already starting to be a bit of a problem that's showing up with pollsters. Have a listen.
I'm happy to know what we want them to talk with the ministers, hear what they have to say, and then we'll consider the decision of them speaking about 10 minutes.
The lack of action on key issues like this, like the gender violence issue, from a Prime Minister that built a persona around, you know, I'm the boy from social housing, public housing, raised by a single mother. Here's a bloke who should have understood what it was like to do it hard and should have been working his butt off for Australians that are doing it hard. And they're not seeing that. So you get this sense of betrayal.
Andrew, what do you reckon?
I reckon it's a bit ScoMo-esque, that particular response. And what happens, as you know, with these guys, Peter, is they take it personally, don't they? They take it personally. They it's ironic that they talk about the role because they forget the role. And the role is not to take it personally. So instead of saying they're taking it as an affront, do you want me to speak or not, I'm the Prime Minister, getting offended and all, you know, this umbrage, you just go, hey, you know, if you want me to speak, I can. If you don't, I'm fine with that too. And then everyone thinks, oh, that's a really reasonable response. It's hard to be on all the time, but he let his guard down there and he reacted badly. And look, he's trying to now avoid the issue, as you pointed out, and all he needs to say is, well, you know, I could have chosen my words better. What's wrong with that? Just an admission.
Yep.
You know, people like when you admit when you're wrong, because none of us are right all the time. Although, as you know, all these politicians think they're right all of the time, Peter.